What's up guys, my name is Benazis Nettles and welcome to Blu-ray Classic Channel, and I'm here to do a movie review and we're going to talk about Terminator, Genesis, whatever you want, whenever you pronounce that word. As you can see right there in my movie theater, they gave out a free poster for Terminator Genesis right there. Yeah, pretty nice. Now I'm going to give you my overall thoughts on this movie. By the way, happy 4th of July, I'll say that, and right now, I'm watching the Twilight Zone, right here. I'm watching the series of Twilight Zone. Great show, yeah, I've not seen this show. Okay, now, Terminator Genesis, off topic, by the way. Terminator Genesis, this is not my most entertaining film, because there's so many sequels that Terminator, I see two sequels from Terminator, has been released in theaters, and if you've seen those, they're awful. Like Terminator Salvation was god awful. Terminator 3 The Rise of the Machine was just even worse. Now we come to Terminator Genesis, and I was very disappointed by the movie. If you see my Instagram, I did my disappointing face. Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of things to say. I will not give you a plot. It's because it's so confusing and it's hard to explain what the plot details about this movie. First we're gonna go to the pros and then we're gonna go to the cons. The pros is there are two things I like about this movie. The first one is the two actors I like in the movie is Arnie and Emilia Clarke. Why? Because there's the only good actress in the film. I'll give you a cons later on, but Amy Clark, she did the best she can to play Sarah Connor. She tried her best playing Sarah Connor. I thought she did good. I thought I like her in this film, even though I love her in Game of Thrones. She played Daenerys Targaryen, Khaleesi, the Mother of Dragons. That's why I buy her in Terminator Genesis. I thought she did good. Arnie, she did good. I mean, he's the only guy who played Terminator as Terminator, as the robot. I mean, he's still Terminator to me. I mean, he did good in this film. And my other post is I love the beginning of the film, showing the war, showing the Terminator versus the human resistance. I love that. And after that, it was kind of downhill. Now, time for the cons. The cons is the writing in this film. The writing in this film is god-awful. It is messed up. I mean, they screwed up the timeline in this film. They even screwed up even worse. I mean, what the hell happened to the script? The script was god-awful. To this day, Hollywood's script is just rushed out. They just rushed out to make a movie, to make money, you know what I mean? To make money. Yeah, that's my cons. The writing was awful, and my other cons is the acting. The few actors, Jason Clarke, for me, he's not John Connor. John Connor to me is like a brave warrior, a brave leader, who cares about humans, who cares about hope. In this film, he just keep talking about the Skynet, you know what I mean? And then Jack Courtney as Kyle Reese, stop it, please stop. Jack Courtney is one of the worst actors ever. Have you seen A Good Day in Die Hard, the fifth Die Hard film. He was god awful in that film. In this film, he had no emotion, no Kyle Reese, unique of Kyle Reese character, and he's one of the worst actors in Hollywood, and he's gonna be in Suicide Squad, and I'm worried about that because he's gonna break Captain Boomerang. And then the other two actors was a complete waste of this film is J.K. Simmons and Matt Smith. If you notice, Matt Smith, he's been playing Doctor Who, he's been playing the 11th Doctor. I believe, no, the 12 Doctors. No, the 11th Doctor, my bad. He's been playing the 11th Doctor for 3 years, and now he's in the film. What a waste of talent! Matt Smith and Jaden Simmons, one of the greatest actors, including Jaden Simmons. He won the Oscar last year. I mean, this year, he won the Oscar this year for Whiplash. And what a waste for him in this movie. He only showed for 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Just a little bit scene, just a little scene. And also Matt Smith, just a little scene, that's it. What a waste, I mean, they could've done better with this character, or they love the, or they can let it out in the cut. Or all this scene will be cut out for them. I mean, Jaden Simmons, I'm sorry, not good for this. He's a great actor, he's one of my favorite actors. Jaden Simmons won the Oscar this year. I wish we could see him more, but he was not. We don't need them. We don't need the character. The character. And the other thing about the cons is, there's some reduced scenes for T2 and Terminator 1. I don't care about this movie. I really don't care about this movie. I knew this movie gonna suck. I wish they can dump it. I wish they can stop this movie. And they reuse. Every time they reuse, it's like, we'll destroy Skynet for after for all. It's the same thing like T2 and Terminator 1. That destroyed Skynet. Blah, blah, blah. We've seen that. It's redundant. I mean, we've seen that over and over and over and over again. Then just stop doing that. And the other reason for cons is the visual effect was okay. I wish they can use practical effect for the Terminator, the robot. You know, it's too late modern day, they use CGI the whole time. And the other thing is, there's some action scene I was like, yeah, there's some action scene that's not good at all. I mean, it's an okay film. It's not like perfect, like T2, Judgment Day. Nothing beats the first two movies. Nothing beats, just like Jurassic World. Nothing beats Jurassic Park. Nothing. And I'm gonna give this movie a 5 out of 10 stars. It's not worth of time seeing in theaters. It's, actually, you can rent a movie if you want, but it's not worth of theater experience. I would rather not watch this movie. I only rather watch T2 and Terminator. I'm in my show with that. I will not put it out. But yeah, what are your thoughts of this movie? And I'll see you guys later.